Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Thank you for tuning in today. This is Sunshine Love, and I hope that you're having a blessed and an awesome day. If you haven't already subscribed, please make sure that you do so by clicking on the subscribe link so you can get the latest videos and notifications. I want to talk about the 26-year-old mother who abruptly ended her life back in June, and I asked, were there signs? Stanlee Holbrook, mother of three, ages 1 through 9. She had two girls and one boy who was the oldest. Holbrook jumped from the Homestead Grays Bridge. She stopped her vehicle in traffic late that evening, left the children in the car, and just went to the bridge, and she just jumped. Now, this bridge is about 249.9 feet in height. So many are wondering why. You know, the Pittsburgh Post posted that there were no signs of struggle. So around 7:20 p.m., like I said, she just parked her car, just put it in park in the middle of traffic on the bridge. She left the children in the vehicle. The children were unharmed, and she went to the railing and she jumped. Now, the bridge is over a river that's about 130 miles long. Emergency responders recovered her body around 9:15 p.m. Now, her neighbors said that she was a dedicated mother who raised three children alone. She was a young mother born October 6, 1992. So Ms. Holbrook was like many single mothers, doing the best that she could to raise her children. However, there were challenges. Neighbors state that one of the children, the youngest, was born premature. So you can imagine the difficulties of dealing with a sick child. The children were taken to the hospital after this incident, and again, they were unharmed, and the children were left in the grandmother's care. Now, we are seeing many young mothers, many young people, period, that are having difficulties facing life and the many obstacles of juggling work and life and being a mom and just dealing with life in general. And it can be difficult at times, and it leads to depression and loneliness and suicide. Now, her neighbor, Miss Joanna, said that she showed no signs that anything was wrong. She had been living in her apartment on Church Hill for about 3 years. She said that she was very close with her children. She took really good care of them. They were well-dressed. They were really taken care of. Now, the youngest child that was born premature, she had a lot of hospital visits, doctor's appointments, and a lot of sleepless nights. And there's another neighbor, Miss Lynette, who said that 2 days before this incident, she seemed to be very tired and like she had been up all night. So we can only imagine what she was going through. Ms. Holbrook had troubles like anyone else. However, dealing with bills and unexpected life events can be very overwhelming. Neighbor stated that she worked jobs. She kept people's children. They said that she was receiving psychiatric care from UPMC, but no family member nor the facility could validate that due to privacy policy. Now, she posted a post, "Everything will fall in place. I'ma just fall back and leave whoever." And then on August the 18th, 2018, she posted another post. And I feel like she's smiling through the pain. Now, she said, this post stated that, "Let the hurt go, move on, boss up, show him what he's missing." So there were relationship issues. There were things that she was battling mentally and emotionally behind the scene. And that's why I think it's so important that we do these welfare checks on our family members and friends. And despite what the situation may or may not be, you know, social media has become very popular these days. So we kind of see these random posts from individuals, and we don't know if they're just posting something or if it's personally identifying to them. And it doesn't hurt to check that out. Now, again, the Pittsburgh Post said that there were no signs of struggle, but she was not sleeping, and she made sure that she posted that periodically on her page, that there were many sleepless nights, and some of it due to her youngest child. And there were other times where she posted that she was not sleeping, just in period. And she posted, "Single mom is no joke. I'm just over people's opinion." So you can imagine that there was probably some personal issues with family members or friends or personal relationships. Another post says that I should be asleep, but I'm up just thinking over. You know, so her mind was probably going a million miles in different direction, just thinking about everything, you know, children, being a single mom, relationship issues, and another post, I'm out. So when we see these posts from family members and friends, it doesn't hurt to just check, you know, send a message or call them, say, hey, is everything okay? Now, another post stated that my son is bad. And, you know, we have one of our children, you know, has a lot of energy and it could be difficult and overwhelming at times. Another post stated that I really think that no one will ever understand me. So are these cries out for help? Was she posting these posts, you know, for help? You know, she was clearly putting her emotions out there, sick of people talking about me. So she was dealing with, you know, loyalty and distrust issues. And that can be hurtful within itself. And a lot of people handle those situations in different ways, but some people keep their emotions and feelings held within. She posted trust issues. And that can be overwhelming within itself. You know, you try to have relationships and friendships, but, you know, you have that side that doesn't trust anybody. Another one, my heart is turning cold. So when you have all these things coming at you and you're constantly giving and giving and giving and not receiving it back, it can be difficult for someone. Now here she posts, can't sleep, life is messed up, this week has been hell. So I really think that just looking at these posts, she was going through some things, although these was months prior. You know, this was building up over a period of time. Another post, my love is unconditional. I always put them first. Three beautiful children who have lost their mother. And I know that she was doing the best that she could to raise them, but it's just so much that she was dealing with from within. Another post, I'm convinced my daughter's a vampire and she was keeping her up at night. And she was trying to be the best mother that she can be and put a smile on her face and do everything that she could to show them that she loved them. But again, she was battling some things from within. Now, funeral services were held back in June at a church back in Pittsburgh, where she's from. A beautiful service, and it's sad that this tragic event happened so quickly and so abruptly. And we have these individuals in our circle and we see different posts and sometimes we see them putting a smile on their face and there are times when we see that they're down. It doesn't take but a second or a minute to reach out to that individual and say, hey, is it everything okay? Is there anything that I can do for you? Not all signs are apparent. Now, she did deal with the loss of a loved one and he died back in 2012. And she did post this picture on her page. Actually, she kept this picture posted periodically and she posted it on her profile. It says, thank you for giving me the biggest, my blessing, baby bone, AKA Say Say. Now, she also refers to baby bone, AKA Say Say, to her oldest little boy, my lover, bone, face, Say Say. So we're thinking that this was the oldest child's father that died. So that can be difficult within itself to deal with the loss of a loved one, and we can't really manage and measure how grieving goes. You know, some people deal with it in different ways, and she was dealing with it the best that she could. And she was also, like I said, she was trying to be the best mother that she could be and doing things with them and spending time with them and also trying to work and deal with all of the things that life was throwing at her. And not everyone has that bestie or that BFF to turn to. Not everyone has that close-knit family or friendship. And we need to make sure that we're reaching out to those people. Now, suicide is one of the top causes of death in the U.S. Nearly 45,000 Americans died just in 2016 alone. So the numbers are increasing and they're rising. And we have people that are just keeping everything bottled from within and they don't know how to deal with it. And there are many warning signs and not all of the warning signs are transparent. And people who commit suicide don't always want to die. They just want their pain to end. So we have to make those welfare checks. We also have to check on these people just to say, hey, are you okay? Is there anything that I can do for you? You know, there are signs that you're going to notice and there's signs that you're not going to notice. But some signs that you can notice are excessive sadness and moodiness, hopelessness, sleep problems, sudden calmness, withdrawal, changes in personality or appearance. You know, so those are some things that we can pay attention to try to help these individuals. And also, if you know anyone that is thinking about suicide or having any type of problems, the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline is open 24/7, and it's free and it's confidential and it's open to anyone who's in need. Please make sure that you get your loved ones the resources and help that they need. Suicide and fighting it is it can be a lot for anyone, especially for people who are feeling lonely and they're battling depression. They're feeling like they have no one to turn to. And if there's anyone who watches this video who needs help, please make sure that you let me know. Reach out to me. I'm more than happy to help. Again, subscribe to my channel by clicking the link below. You have a great one. Thank you for tuning into my channel. Please make sure again that you subscribe so you can get the latest videos. And also, I'm going to end this video with giving help is better than not helping at all. There's so much going on in this world today. We have to make sure that we help each other. Have a great one.